Hello and welcome to TCGS Talks over E3 2021. And tonight we're talking over the Capcom event. Guys, before we went live, I said the good thing about Discord is you don't really have to do anything.
Has it gone wrong?
It's just gone a little tiny bit wrong, but that's fine. That's fine. We can talk amongst ourselves. James, what are you looking forward to
Going
Capcom
to bed
announcing?
after this, but yeah, but
That's the spirit.
no. I'm
Be
really
damned.
hoping. I'm really hoping for more Phoenix Wright would be nice. That's something I really care about in this, honestly, my main thing. I like a lot of Capcom games, though. I mean, Resident Evil, I'd be happy to see any whatever they got for that, but mostly Phoenix.
Well,
Cool.
I think you'll be in luck, Sean. How about you? I mean, Monster Hunter.
Monster Hunter. I'm basically just here to see what's going on with Monster Hunter Rise. I'm intrigued to see if they'll mention the alleged PC port. Not. I mean, I'd probably still play it on Switch anyway. Just curious to see what the plan is, and also just see how they're going to support it going forward. Because I don't think it's had. There's not been any like massive events for it like they were doing with Monster Hunter World. That might be wrong. But I've not heard anyone like buzzing about it particularly. Even though the game's brilliant, it's sort of there was yeah, I don't know, there was like an initial flurry and then everyone sort of went quiet.
Yeah, because
So I don't
I
know, it's
remember
gonna be
hearing
interesting.
loads of people saying that they've left the console one, they're playing on PC, and then they're not happened after that. So there was a tweet already about what is going to be shown tonight, James, but you say you didn't want to know. I mean, it said some of the stuff that's going to be shown tonight, at least. But you don't want to know about that, do you, James?
I kind of like it to be a surprise, but I mean, Sean, do you already know what everything is now then?
No, I remember seeing the list. I don't remember everything. I just remember seeing Monster Hunter Rise on it and going, right, good. There'll definitely be a bit about Monster Hunter Stories too as well, which I'm not really asked about, but we'll see.
We again, I mean, I hate having to ask this every time, but do we have any idea how long this is? This
No.
just
Oh God, all of our cameras are just picked. I shouldn't have said. I should not have said that at all, should I?
jinxed it
I literally
big
have
time.
jinxed it. My God. Yeah, I shouldn't have said it. Okay, it's all right. We got plenty of time. How weird. How weird it would do that. But there you go. Okay. Well, yeah. So. Yeah, there's definitely time. It starts in 7 minutes. We've got ages. Why? Why
What?
has it done this? Why? Where? Why
Still
can't?
going wrong?
Yeah, just can't. Do I have to add Discord again? No, surely not. This can't be right. I mean, I really did jinx it. I really shouldn't have said. I really shouldn't have said anything, should I? Okay, I'm actually gonna leave Discord. Maybe hang on, where was Discord? Oh, it's. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. Give it to that. It
All
was
good.
fucking hell, mate.
Simon Sloth 123 says we're looking good.
Are we
I assume
now?
that's sarcasm because we're not currently on screen. Is that right?
We are kind of on, kind of.
Oh,
We're kind of on stream. I mean, it's mad. How much it's fucked up, basically. It's quite insane. It's okay. In fact, no, it's just me. It's just me. It's just me.
okay.
I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing. Anyway, yeah. So, Resident Evil Village came out. I wonder if there'll be DLC. It feels a bit early for that. James, how soon was the Resident Evil 7 DLC out after that?
I don't remember. Maybe about 6 months or so. I thought it was around that.
Oh, right.
I couldn't tell you for certain. I mean, I'm just correct. I don't.
Sure, there'll be no Resi 7, Village DLC already, but who knows? Maybe that's a possibility.
Mean, even if it was just a tease or something, right? That'd be fine. Because yeah, with Seven, didn't they? The DLC was all like post-credit stuff, wasn't it?
Yes.
So, yeah, I don't know. Maybe they could tease something, but who knows?
Yeah.
Oh shit, Simon Sloth has gifted a load of subs.
Simon Sloth, you crazy person. Thank what you, Simon, for gifting us up to G-Trat underscore, Leon Score Morris, John Tempelli, Red Eskimo 95, and Saint RG. Thank you ever so much, Simon Sloth, you crazy person.
Thank you.
You absolute, absolutely mad person. Right, okay, let's move all these people in the right position. Yeah, so as James said, we don't know how long it's going to be.
I was banking on less than an hour, I'll be honest.
I'd be very surprised if it's, I'm thinking like 40 minutes, maybe an hour. Surely no more than that. You've got to imagine.
We'll see.
We got Nintendo. Are we doing Nintendo tomorrow? I don't remember.
Yes, we're doing Nintendo. I mean, I've got work, but I'm just gonna say, look, I'm doing this thing, and I've got to leave early and I work late and stuff. But
what time is it? Is it five?
It's at five. Yeah. I mean, can you even do that, James?
Probably.
Definitely be watching it, but I'll have Isaac with me, so he will not let me do a talks over unless you want him on it. But
probably
get bored after 10 minutes and demand to watch fucking Coco Melon again or something. So,
we don't know how many of us are gonna be on here basically tomorrow for this for the Nintendo one. I will probably be here, but don't really want to do it on my own. So we'll see.
I'll do whatever I can to be here. Put it that way. Whatever I can, because I really do want to. I want to do that one. And it's going to be awful, but I think it'll be entertaining. So
it does now feel like we're not going to see any hardware, doesn't it? Like,
no, we're not.
Switch Pro's just not going to.
Yeah, can't see it happening.
Revealed.
I think we're going to see a lot of things that are already out. I think we might see in this one. Hope is not high.
Yeah.
We'll see.
Yeah. So maybe it'll be myself and James. Maybe someone will be here to talk over Nintendo. That's all. That's all that matters.
I mean, I might send Asher to do it. So he'll be well up for that. Yeah,
yeah, he likes his Nintendo stuff. Anyway.
Well, probably show
absolutely
me up.
Loves it. Yeah.
Get Dave on.
Well, yeah. Might as well. Speaking of which, we've just dropped the new David Turner's Daily for today.
Yeah.
Sorry, it's a little bit late. Mm-hmm. It's not the weekend now, so we have to go to work. So today's David Turner's Daily is out now, and there will be a new one the next day or so, which will be our final David Turner's Daily, unfortunately, until about 3 years, or 3 or 4 years at the next E3. There's a lot to go over, shall we say.
There's some shocking revelations, but we've saved the best for last, haven't
we? As of now,
we don't know what else we're going to see.
Yeah, as of 22, 28 on the 14th, I mean, I think more will change. I mean, yeah. You'll see what we mean when you listen to the pod, but how do they not call David Turner's Daily simply the Turner Diaries? Well, because because it was kind of not a parody, but it's basically the same as the Totally Football Show Euro 2020 Daily. Yeah. That's where we got the idea from. Like, well, we have daily Euro 2020 podcasts, we have daily E3 podcasts. Now it feels like with the amount of revelations coming out of David's online activities, shall we say, we need a daily podcast to clearly go over all the stuff he's done. It was never the plan. We're doing talks over every day, got our jobs and families. We didn't think, oh, how about we do a daily podcast? But
no, it was absolutely not in the plan. But I think it's worked out quite well though. I've quite enjoyed
it. It's been really fun. It's a shame that it's like a logistical impossibility to do it long term, because it's been really nice.
Mm. Yeah, it's so good. Just like, I mean, we literally recorded it 15, 20 minutes ago, recorded it, edited it, published, and it's like, it's not quite nice out. Yeah, short and sweet.
Yeah, yeah. Because I always like the idea of, because I'm not going to say the name, but your virtual assistant that you may have on your phone or in your house, you can set up a podcast as like a news source. So that when you get up, you say like, okay, whatever.
Yeah, tell me what's happening in my day today.
Yeah. So you could have like a games one, right? And how cool would that be? Just like every night, just record a little 10-minute thing. Here's what's happened, bit of chat, whatever. Yeah. And then just bang that out for everyone the following morning. I think that'd be lovely.
Yeah.
Let's do it, Sean. Let's look into Guinness Book of Records. Has there been I mean, obviously, there's been a daily podcast, but hasn't been a gaming one every day for a year. That's a challenge.
It's a challenge. I mean, Polygon did that for a while. They did mini map, which was was quite good actually. I quite enjoyed it. Yeah, and then they killed it. Like they do every one of their podcasts. Yeah, they never last like very long. So it was good.
That's a shame.
Yeah.
Are Capcom late? I mean, I'm on the official Capcom channel. Let's see what the chat are saying. late. I mean, no, I'm on the Capcom USA one. 18,000 people are watching.
Colin.
Oh.
Don't be a smart ass.
Here we go.
The whole point of the conversation was what I was saying is, yeah, it's too hard to do. That's why we're not doing it. I was just saying, it'd be nice.
Yeah.
Back off. Hey, Hazelio. Thanks for the sub.
Well, here we go.
24 months.
Oh, it's kicked off and it's very loud.
Oh, goodness, so it is.
Welcome to the Capcom E3 Showcase. I'm your host, Rachel Querico, a.k.a. Seltzer, and I'll be your guide as we walk through the latest releases, news, and updates from Capcom. We'll hear from the Resident Evil Village team, share some news from the world of Monster Hunter, and get the latest on Ace Attorney. Then we'll wrap up with some updates from our friends at Capcom Fighters. So what are we waiting for? Let's get started. Our first stop today, Resident Evil Village.
Nice.
Resident Evil franchise continues to pioneer the latest and greatest in survival horror. The team has been blown away by the response to Resident Evil Village, which launched last month. It brought the world another chapter in this decades-long story as the franchise celebrates its 25th anniversary this year.
You're not into fighting games, I'm sure, no?
Able to introduce Tsuyoshi Kanda,
Screen. I'm so sorry, everyone. Jesus, I am the worst, aren't I?
A special message for the fans.
Literally the worst person on the planet.
Another time.
Ethan Winters? Probably gonna be mad spoilers in this, isn't it?
Surely not. It's only been out a month.
Yeah.
I think it's time you left things in my hands.
We're getting a trailer.
Go on, rest now.
Oh, it's just a.
This is just the game.
Yeah. It's just a new trailer.
Hi everyone. Weird. My name is Tsuyoshi Kanda, producer on Resident Evil Village. I wanted to take this opportunity to thank everyone who's prayed since we launched the game in May. We hope you're enjoying this new chapter in survival horror. As a reminder, everyone who purchases Resident Evil Village will gain free access to our online multiplayer title, Resident Evil Reverse, where players go head-to-head with their favorite Resident Evil heroes and bioweapons. I'm now happy to announce that Resident Evil Reverse will go live next month across all supported platforms. So head into the fray to celebrate the Resident Evil 25th anniversary.
I mean, it doesn't look as good, I'll be honest.
No.
Well, popular demand.
Hey, hang on. What? It's Colin Ross Wilson's birthday?
Thank you, Kanda-san, for that wonderful update. It is. Next up, some long-awaited news from the world of Monster Hunter.
Happy birthday, Colin.
Whether it's adventuring alongside monsters or battling them with friends,
we've got something for you. Colin Ross Wilson.
First, let's dive into the brand new story-based RPG entry to the series.
Get us emotes
in the
chat.
Monster Hunter Stories 2, Wings of Ruin.
That announcement was incredible. Did you see that?
Well, what did she say?
Just some text on the screen saying, we are doing some DLC, more info later.
Yeah. It's by popular demand, like you weren't going to do it anyway.
Do you know, right? The first one was on the 3DS, and it also came out on mobile. And I noticed a few weeks back that it was like £3 on the Google Play Store. I was like, yeah, do you know what? I'll have a go for £3. Why not?
What is this?
This is Monster Hunter Stories 2.
Oh, okay, but it was that thing they just showed it.
For the first one, it was on sale. So I was like, yeah, fuck it. And then when I went back to actually get it was back up to £20. Not that king.
It's like TK Maxx. If you see something in there, you got to buy it there and then because you won't see it again.
Yeah, we'll never see it again.
That's when I met you.
Whenever they show these games, it's always just cutscenes. I don't actually know what type of game it is. Or like how the fights work or anything. Destiny.
This is the legendary monster.
I can't remember what, maybe it's on sale again.
The monster with the legendary monster.
There's a wish list on the Play Store.
Many people believe there's a connection between the strange happenings and the wings of ruin. The pits are appearing everywhere.
What do you think? Do you like the look of that legendary monster, Sean?
Strange light.
Did look legendary, to be fair. Yeah. Nice, 20 quid. And apparently the 3DS version goes for shitloads on eBay as well. Not very hard to find.
What's this whole idea of forming kinship with monsters? How do you control them?
It's not about control. Monsters help riders of their own will. And the bonds between monsters and riders are just like your bond with Tsukino.
It's Pokemon, isn't it? I don't mean just controlling monsters, but the whole, like, oh, I believe in being friends with them, and the baddies going, oh, no, that's stupid. No, it isn't. All I have are questions. That's how you get the best out of them, mate, actually.
If there's worry or doubt in your voice, Ratha will become anxious, too. He needs to know that you will protect him no matter what.
I can sense the flames of his life force weakening. The burden of such great power is too much for his body to bear.
Just in the chat.
A voice. Can you hear it?
Riders can bond with monsters. Surely you can groove with fellow humans.
They have the power of kinship.
Yep.
They're friends. They're monsters. Humans carry.
Oh, it's interesting because I don't know what sort of numbers. That makes them. I don't know what sort of numbers the last one did.
Probably very good.
Yeah.
Well, I don't know, because it was pre... I'm pretty sure it's before World came out.
Mm-hmm.
It's obviously the big moment in the West for Monster Hunter. So, I don't know.
But these are all massive in, like as I said, like, when I lived in China, I saw people playing them all the time, like, on the train.
But they're all playing it. But what type of game is it? We didn't see any gameplay.
Well, there was a bit of combat. It appeared to be, like, a sort of arena-based...
I mean, I'm not going to get now. I'm not getting now because it said monsties. So,
something new, or is this a continuation?
This is still just stories too. Yeah.
Oh, still stories too. Jesus. Nice little outfit.
New monster Palamute.
Oh,
nice. Okay, so you can ride the Palamute as a monster. Okay, so there's going to be a demo.
Fun. An amiibo.
Looks pretty epic, right?
Cat fella and how in about the bottom that right. announcement? Did you see that?
The canine companion Palamute from Monster Hunter Rise will be joining Monster Hunter Stories 2 as one of the new monsties in the first free title update coming soon after the game's
release.
I don't like the
use of monsties.
You can get an early peek at the game with the Monster Hunter Stories 2 Wings of Ruin trial version starting on June 25th, which also carries your progress over to the full game release just a few weeks later on July 9th. That's not the only way to join the hunt. Millions of you made Monster Hunter Rise a huge success.
Oh, what? It's not even
available
on release.
And we have even more content coming,
including
a new collaboration on the
Rise. I'm waiting for her to say monsters again because I'm like watching Matt's face every time she says it.
Stop saying monsters. Another monster.
No.
This is for my fellow hunters.
See, the collaborations are often really fun. I hope it's Captain Jack Sparrow again.
So, well, these other Capcom IPs within the game?
Yeah, well, they've had all sorts.
Okay. I want Ethan Winters.
Maybe.
To battle a monster.
No, he's one of the monsters and you have to hack his fucking arms off.
He's good at himself.
hang on, so are they putting Monsters in Monster Hunter Rise?
I just don't think so.
Well,
you can already ride the monsters around in Rise, but you don't like you're not like permanent mates with them.
Oh, the Palico layered armor that looked quite cool actually.
I mean, that's not that exciting. Here we go. Event quests, so basically not really anything new then. Event quests tend to just be like, oh, here's like a mission where it's just a different configuration of monsters that you might not have put together yet.
Oh, okay.
I'm into the shades though.
Oh no, yeah, arrow shades, yeah.
Yeah, man.
There's so much stuff going on. There's no time to read that roadmap.
There has never been a better time to be a Monster Hunter fan. With all the new updates to Monster Hunter Rise and the launch of Monster Hunter Stories 2 this summer, we can't wait to hear about your own stories of adventure.
Oh, okay. Oh, I think you might be quite a bit ahead then. I've only just seen the roadmap.
Capcom has in store for us this July. Fans of Phoenix Wright will have new chapters to explore.
What were you just saying?
The release of the Great
It's back on the lady describing everything again.
North American and European future attorneys will finally be able to get their hands on the Great Ace Attorney Adventures and the Great Ace Attorney 2 Resolve, which were previously only available in Japan.
Hey.
Let's travel back in time to the late 19th century Japan and London to play as Ryunosuke Naruhodo, Phoenix Wright's ancestor, in this action-packed prequel. Now, let's hear more about the story.
She's very enthusiastic.
So then, let us unravel this mystery.
Welcome to the center of the
world. I'm excited for this. Great Britain's mighty capital. But I really wish that they'd released the other three as well. But they still haven't done. And it's nice.
Played them for the 10th time.
Yeah, no, I haven't played them. That's the thing. Sometimes I've only played once or twice, and it's okay.
What are the other three exactly?
No, like Apollo Justice and Dual Spirits and stuff like that. There was like a whole bunch.
Are they all well regarded then? Because I sort of got the impression that the shine had come off by that point. But
yeah, but they were still good. Okay. They just weren't as good as the originals. Yeah. They're still about them.
I can't believe all of them are now available on Switch.
I know, it doesn't make any sense.
It seems like an open goal, doesn't it?
Mm.
The defense demands its right to a cross-examination.
Mac, you turn my mic down, apparently it's too loud.
Your testimony completely contradicts the facts.
You were excited for the first time all night.
Yeah.
Everyone's got fucking hell.
Objection! Yeah, I've turned you a bit down now.
With all due respect, this is an outrage!
Oh, someone said turn you up. Okay, you're now 500% off.
Yeah, I'm forward to it. Because it looks, I mean, look how nice it looks as well.
Yeah.
So we have
I know you never would, but I'd love to see you stream it, James.
No,
where you can take on the role of a defense attorney. Now, we all want to see some
Matt, are we sure?
Right?
Have you ever played
Let's
one of these?
Let's take a closer first look at two gameplay features new to the franchise in the Great Ace Attorney Chronicles. Dance of Deduction
and,
Summation Examination.
But didn't get into them in the same way.
Oh no,
hello.
This trailer says minor
Capcom's
spoilers may be included. James, you might have to look away.
So this is the capital of Great Britain.
Where to?
The Supreme Court in Whitehall, if you wouldn't mind.
The Capcom team is thrilled to present two new gameplay features.
This is the bit.
Every time I refresh it to try and catch up, I'll get further behind.
Well investigated.
British Taylor on that sign there.
Citizens.
I don't know if they bothered to specify that in Britain.
That require further examination. With the help of
this is the only thing that is sometimes not so good with these games, is the like the gimmick that they have or whatever for, you know, adding a gameplay feature, and they're not always good.
Yeah.
Sometimes they're great, but some...
Herlock will proceed to present his logic and reasoning spectacular. A grandiose
James, Mr. Bedford wants to know, with regard to Yakuza, should they start with 1 or 0?
I've already dealt with that.
Oh yeah, in a chat. So you have. You've done. You could talk. No. You could talk to him now, using
ask
your voice.
Next.
But you wrote in chat.
Yeah. Well, I'm enjoying this trailer.
Good point. Yeah. No. I've dealt with it, Matt. Do you think they need to be showing this, James?
Quite long. But I mean, that appears to be the format they're going with tonight.
Yeah.
We'll then discuss to correct.
Tom, this is better than that Monster Hunter stuff.
Whatever.
Better than Code
I
Media.
Do wish they'd fully voice these.
At this point, players will be prompted to search for clues.
I don't know.
But then, of course, people play them on the train with the sound off, don't they?
That's true.
That was one time. That was one journey. It wasn't even a whole game. It was one journey. Just because I heard all my life, people saying my normal life, everyone saying, oh, podcast game. I'm like, oh, I'll try what it is. People saying, listen to podcasts, make games, and see what it's like. I didn't like it. And yet I'm the one labeled as a podcast listening gameplay on the train. No.
Enter into a
one time.
Semi-literal dance that brings them to the conclusion of the
someone in the YouTube chat saying, where's Dragon's Dogma? It's a great question.
Yeah.
I don't think we'll be seeing anything of it. I mean, they even made a fucking anime about it.
Like, so it must be popular enough for them to, if they make an anime.
This is it. And they just, like, they keep porting it to every new console comes out. Weird.
But you said the anime was really bad, right?
It was just a bit pointless. It was sort of too similar and yet to, and what am I trying to say? It was like really similar to the game, but just the changes weren't interesting. It was just really odd. It was like I'd either want it to like really closely follow the game or be completely different, and it was kind of, I don't know, sort of trod the middle ground and was a bit weird as a result. Whereas like the Castlevania series is so clearly like, you know, influenced, but it's like its own thing, but has loads of nods, you know, for people who love the series.
Did you see what the next one's going to be? Yeah, no. It's apparently set in Paris during it's Scott Richter. It's going to be the main.
Their progress will be displayed and represented by two scales of justice: black representing a guilty verdict, and one white representing a not guilty
good
verdict.
Objection. The ending was pretty good. On
examination, take the stand to face off against the jurors, all of whom provide explanations.
We've
as to
the
why
same
they
gavel sound effect.
Guilty
that's amazing.
You'll have to identify conflicting statements and sway the jury in your favor.
This is going on a long old time.
Yeah, but this is also really different to before. Like they've never had a jury
like
before.
Specific jurors. Yeah.
Objection.
Be ready to provide evidence from the court record to help prove the contradiction in their claims.
Oh wow, this is really complex.
When you successfully point out one of these contradictions among the jurors, you might just change their minds too. With a slam of their fist, each juror you persuade will send a fiery ball towards
Netflix
the scales
Castlevania
above and literally
calls
tip the scales of justice in your favor.
Don't think that would work.
Bring each contradiction to light and persuade the jury to help prove your client's innocence.
Objection. I wonder how this is going to work, because this came out quite a long time ago and they didn't localize it.
Oh, really?
Does that mean this system doesn't work very well? it's
we're very excited
because it wasn't in any other game.
Yeah.
New fans and diehard fans alike.
That thanks looks really good, watching actually. I might play
it. It already seems like I have a bunch of games to catch up on. There are some exciting new adventures and titles to look forward to. Well, that's a look at the new premieres from Capcom, but what about esports? Let's close out today's showcase with a few words from two of the stars of Capcom Fighters, RobTV and Vicious. They'll tell us what's been going on with Capcom Esports, including updates on the Capcom Pro Tour, Intel World Open, Street Fighter League. I'm ahead of you, but Capcom Fighters.
Let me know when you get
over to you guys.
Oh, is it esports time?
Oh, it's esports time.
Yeah, she said that's it. Said we're closed out of esports now.
What's going on, everybody, and welcome to the Capcom Esports presentation for E3.
Is that it then? Oh, that's just the.
She said that that's it for the. Here with the game, the exclusive reveals. Now let's close out with esports.
Rob TV, what's going on, Rob?
Oh my goodness, Vicious, host extraordinaire. That just sounds beautiful. It has a ring to it, and I think that's the perfect word to describe what we have for everyone today.
What?
Street Fighter V, Capcom E3.
Sorry, I just had a visceral feeling about esports.
Nice. Nice.
No, look, people love this stuff.
I know, I just not one of them.
Competitive Street Fighter 5 is. Yeah. The long and the short of it is this. We travel all around the world, state to state, country to country, and we try to bring our opponent's life bar.
I'm sort of like the Monster Hunter Stories 2 stuff that now just made me annoyed again that I didn't get the original game for £3. Sign up a month ago.
Yeah, that's Matt. So, yeah, so I haven't said it. But just pony up 17 quid extra quid, Sean. You're just going to have to now. Although the sequel's out soon, so just go straight into that.
I know, but I feel like I should give the first a go because the sequel's not out for a bit yet. Or the demo's on the 24th. Yeah.
Do you know how long those games even are?
Not a clue.
That's not what's really at stake here. It's about making it to the granddaddy of them all, Capcom Cut.
Just reset in grand finals of Capcom Cup.
So behind me, you can see in all of its glory,
£20
Capcom Pro Tour 2021 official stage and set. And
that's a place that you're I think the 3DS one is actually expensive.
We broadcast it live from this stage, and we check out all of the top competitors from each and every one of these regions. And speaking of, the Capcom Pro Tour has shaped up a lot. 2021, we have 32 events going on in the Capcom Pro Tour, spanning across 19 different territories. So there's so many opportunities for players from around the world.
The CD keys do 3DS games.
I'm absolutely excited because again,
I don't, I can't remember like what the deal is with buying digital Nintendo games anyway.
Is your first qualifier for Japan for the Capcom Pro
Tour? Not only can you get that's what I wasn't sure about. Yes, Simon Slot 123. Where was the Dino Crisis remake? Show off the Dino Crisis or something. I don't know, tease the next kind of Resi remake. There was nothing there. There was a slightly re-edited Resident Evil Village trailer, which we didn't need because it came out 2 minutes ago. A message saying, well, by popular demand, we're going to do DLC. Like we're going, they're good anyway.
Lindy, what do you mean we need to talk about my 3DS?
I get it.
But now you actually have your team.
I mean, to pay for it, I just wanted to pay a lot less for it.
Does this rank below Square Enix? I think it probably does.
I mean,
let's not forget the Intel World opening is happening
It really does.
Now.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, but like you're really excited about Ace Attorney. I'm really excited about more Monster Hunter stuff.
True. Yeah.
But
be sure to check we already knew about them.
We already knew about them. They're not even current standings and they're not news, are they? They're not. To commemorate this
event, everyone and they weren't presented in a particularly exciting way either.
No.
Do you know what I mean?
Once again, PC Gaming Show rises above.
Yeah.
I didn't think that. Before going into this E3 week, I didn't think, you know what, PC Gaming Show probably like top three or four.
I mean, although honestly, I mean, SummerSloth, even with this esports section, this is still better than the Koch Media one.
It's pronounced Coke.
Seriously. Koch.
I know you're definitely excited about that. 100%.
Koch.
I mean, of course, your boy is from Ohio. Make sure you guys tune in to see the tournament. You do not want to miss some of the best Street Fighter V players in the world compete head to head.
Honestly, I'd rather watch esports than that. Because that was the worst.
This is a game about being a world warrior.
Everyone in the YouTube chat is going nuts, obviously. People saying you had an entire conference just for this. This game has changed the lives of several people saying Crapcom.
Oh,
very good.
Shit.
Very good.
They did it. Scientologist, yes, you have missed the whole thing. You haven't missed much at all.
I mean, you know the Square Enix one. Like that, but worse.
Guys, even less. Really exciting
maybe there'll be one more thing.
To see how this plays out on the road to Capcom Cup.
I mean, that's what we're now holding on for, isn't it? We've made it this far.
Twitch and YouTube channels for more information and to watch the latest matches.
One more
thing. So that's a wrap for Capcom at E3 this year.
There's not going to be.
Let's recap what we all saw. Resident Evil Village is back with the latest installment of the survival horror experience and RE-verse as part of the franchise's 25th anniversary. We have new adventures to embark on in the world of Monster Hunter with Monster Hunter Stories 2, Wings of Ruin, and Monster Hunter Rise. And don't forget to go back in time with the great Ace Attorney Chronicles to tap into the family history of Phoenix Wright and solve new cases. Finally, don't miss out on the esports fun.
I mean, I'll be honest. I mean, selfishly, I'm quite pleased that this has only been half an hour.
But don't go anywhere yet. Join the conversation on Twitter and make sure you check out the Capcom virtual booth on the E3 portal to watch all these videos again and more. I'm Rachel Querico, aka Seltzer. Thank you.
That's the thing. Why do they even have this? I mean, is it just so that they can feel or they can show that they're relevant and one of the big boys or something?
Yeah, that was absolutely not needed.
Yeah, I would assume it's. Stakeholders have insisted upon it.
So is this all because there's not like a stage show, there's no Sony, so everyone else is like, well, we better do our own now.
Might as well. Yeah.
Or they're like, well,
you can choose not to.
Yeah. Or I guess
you can just make.
Because it feels like there's too many, and these weren't needed.
I mean, this stuff could be folded into like Summer Games Fest or something. Do you know what I mean?
Exactly.
It's fine if you just do a show like that. Yeah.
He knows what he's doing.
You just do a third party show, of just this sort of stuff.
You could drop one of the rubbish bits he had and stick this in. It'd be fine.
Yeah, like they showed nothing. They had nothing. Like,
can you imagine?
Like, yeah, we know. We finished it. It came out a month ago. We know it's back.
Yeah, but you're going to get access to that pretty poor looking multiplayer game.
Yeah,
the RE-verse, not reverse.
No, man.
Anyway, so that was.
Well, that was.
I'll tell you what, I'm really grateful that EA are not doing. I'm really glad that EA are not doing one now, that it's like a month away.
They're doing one in July, aren't they?
Because otherwise, we'd have that to go through as well, of probably the same sort of thing.
So the fact EA doing it in a month's time, maybe. Well, you'd like to think within the next month we'll have a Sony one as well.
Yeah, you'd hope so.
You'd like to think that if they have something to show.
IGN Summer of Gaming presented by USAA Insurance. I'm gonna go and get myself some of that insurance, lads.
Yes,
sounds good.
We should go
now. My insurance, I've got. I'm sorted. Yeah, got everything.
Gamescom is August, I think. So Great Attorney, that was July 27th?
Yeah, it was July
27th, 29th?
Yeah, it was around that time.
Yeah. We're going to go, but let's raid someone. Yeah?
Who's on?
Let's raid. Zaffer Cakes is online. Y2 Ken is online.
It's basically Zaffer Cakes, that's all I've got.
Let's raid. Good family man. Right, okay, awesome. Yeah, so thank you ever so much, Evan, for watching. It's been dreadful.
Joining us.
No, it's been awesome to have you here, but my God, Capcom, that was not needed. But tomorrow, UK time, 10 to 5, we'll be live to talk over the Nintendo Direct at E3 2021. That could be good. It could be bad.
Who knows? It could be really bad.
That is tomorrow at 10 to 5. And also tomorrow evening, it's Bandai Namco. We're still doing that, right, guys?
Are we?
Oh, yeah. What time's it on? It's like, it's another late one, isn't it?
Yeah.
I mean, after this one, part of me thinks like, well, we absolutely shouldn't, but also I feel like we have to at this point.
Well, you know.
Surely we've seen the worst.
Well, yeah. Why would we do all this and not finish it with, There's
I
one.
Mean, it's going to be Elden Ring, isn't it? For like brilliant. The for like half an hour or something.
That's lovely,
that's,
old job.
Yeah, I'm all right with that.
I'll see that. Yeah.
Quite happy to learn more about Elden Ring.
Cool. Okay, we're going to raid Zaffa Cakes, who's playing Brian Lara Cricket, I think. So he is Brian Lara International. We're going to raid him. Thank you ever so much, everyone, for watching. Thanks to the subs. Thanks to the follows. Thanks for watching with us back here tomorrow for Nintendo and Bandai Namco. Have a great rest of the evening, whatever you're doing. Look after yourselves. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.